Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome to St. Andrew. We're happy you have joined us as we celebrate the Most Holy Trinity. I'm Carmen Berguglio. The lectures for this Mass are myself and Linda Martins. Our music will be led by Stefan Paul. Our cantor is Rick Rumbelski. Serving the Mass are Dominic and Gabby Berguglio and Gabriella and Philip Wenner. The presider for this liturgy is Father Brian, assisted by Deacon Tom. To minimize distractions during the Mass, we ask you to silence all cell phones and personal devices. Now please stand and greet your neighbor.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, let
Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. God, our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, power, and majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up Mount Sinai as the Lord had commanded him, taking along the two stone tablets. Having come down in a cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, the Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, if I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people, yet pardon our wickedness and sins and receive us as your own. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory and praise forevermore. Glory and praise forevermore. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Blessed is your holy and glorious name. Praiseworthy and exalted above all for all ages. Glory and praise forevermore. Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory. Praiseworthy and glorious above all forever. Glory and praise forevermore. Blessed are you in the throne of your kingdom. Praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Glory and praise forevermore. Blessed are you who look into the depths.
from the throne upon the cherubim. Praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Glory and praise forevermore.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice. Mend your ways. Encourage one another. Agree with one another. Live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
On Wednesday, which is the feast of the Visitation of Our Lady, I was driving around on my way to an appointment, actually, and when I got about halfway there, halfway to Port Huron, it was canceled. So there I was kind of rolling around northern Macomb County, and I had a very great sense that I should go pray. And so I got out my phone, and I began to look up churches, but it was that time of day where the offices were all closing. And then I thought, you know what? Even though all these big parishes are closing for the afternoon, I'm going to drive to Armada. I'm going to go to St. Mary Mystical Rose, and hopefully, somehow, I'll get in. Well, sure enough, I got there. And there was a car by the rectory, and I've never been in this little church, but I've always wanted to go, and I knocked on the door and explained who I was. In fact, they said what I hear all the time, "You're getting Father Joe Horn." Yes, we are. Can I go pray? And they let me in and said, "Well, be sure to lock the door." Oh, no kidding, I'll do that. No, it was wonderful. I love the hospitality. And as I sat there in that beautiful church before the Blessed Sacrament, I was filled with gratitude. Gratitude that this wonderful Eucharistic faith unites us. And I never want to take for granted the Holy Eucharist. Next week is Corpus Christi Sunday, the body and blood of the Lord. And after 3 years, we will once again be offering the precious blood at each of our weekend and weekday masses. Now, in the bulletin this week on page 4, there's some great information about the reception of the Holy Eucharist that you may find helpful. For example, we are reminded that Jesus Christ, body and blood, soul and divinity, is fully present in the host and in the precious blood. This is known as concomitance. As such, the entire self of Jesus is present in the sacred host alone and the precious blood alone, because he cannot be divided. Therefore, nothing is missing when we receive the Holy Eucharist under one form. However, the Church also teaches that when we receive the Eucharist under both forms, sacred body and precious blood, we are privileged to experience the fuller sign of the Eucharistic banquet, as Christ demonstrated at the Last Supper. Whether or not you intend to partake of the precious blood next weekend, there are a few things that I'd like to mention. I guess this is kind of an instructional mass. When receiving the body of Christ, the sacred host should be consumed reverently, completely, and immediately. It is inappropriate to carry the host away. If you should find a sacred host left in a pew or on the ground, please notify me or Father Grayson or our deacons or Nikki immediately so we can consume the host and purify the area. If you're interested in bringing the Holy Eucharist to a sick or homebound neighbor or family member, please use a PYX, which is specifically designed for this. If you do not own a PYX, the parish does have some that could be signed out. The PYX is a sacred vessel, like the chalice and the paten used at Mass. So it needs to be purified after being used, which I am always happy to do. For the foreseeable future, there will only be two ministers for the precious blood at each Mass, stationed on either side of the main aisle. If you'd like to receive the precious blood, please sit nearby, maybe in the main body of the church. I am concerned that if you are too far to travel, you will miss out. When receiving the precious blood, the minister presents the chalice saying the blood of Christ. After making a gesture of reverence, such as a simple bow of the head, just like when receiving the sacred host, and responding amen, the minister will hand the chalice to you. While you sometimes see priests intinct, that is, dip the host into the chalice, please do not do this. Only bishops and priests are permitted to receive by self-intinction. As we announce at each wedding and funeral, we ask that if you're not Catholic or you are not prepared to receive the Holy Eucharist, please cross your arms when you come forward to the priest or deacon, and we will give you a blessing. If you go to an extraordinary minister of Holy Communion, they will say a prayer for you. Finally, I'd like to invite you to participate in our solemn Corpus Christi Eucharistic procession next Sunday, June 11, immediately following the 12 p.m. Mass. Weather permitting, we will process with the Blessed Sacrament, going outside via the south entrance, the door closest to the school, process down the driveway to the sidewalk, turn right, and process up the other driveway, entering the church at the north entrance near the rectory, and gathering back here for benediction. Our first communicants are invited to be a part of this procession in their first communion apparel and take a special place of honor with their families in the procession immediately behind me with the Blessed Sacrament. Let me take this occasion to say how much I appreciate the love and devotion for the Holy Eucharist that I witness here at St. Andrew each day in our parishioners. It is clear to me that the people and ministers of our parish have long had a great understanding of and appreciation for the Blessed Sacrament. And it's very humbling to be the one to oversee the return of the distribution of the precious blood here, as well as so many other ministries that we stopped during the pandemic. I am especially excited for the children who received First Holy Communion in 2020, 2021, 2022, and 2023, and the adults who received in the Catholic Church during those years to finally have the opportunity to receive the precious blood. I'd also like to thank Nikki and all the extraordinary ministers of Holy Communion for doing the hard work of making the return of the precious blood for our parishioners possible here at St. Andrew. There are a lot of logistics to doing liturgy well, but the effort is well worth it because liturgy is the worship of God. And as you heard in the Holy Gospel today, God so loved the world that he gave his only Son so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. Unite with the church throughout the world. Let us profess our faith and say, I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. Look forward to the resurrection of the dead and a life of the world to come. Amen. Confident that God is merciful and slow to anger, let us join in offering our prayers and petitions to the Lord.
For the church, that we may recognize our call to be children of God, be united in fellowship through the Holy Spirit, and encourage one another as we follow God's call in our lives. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace throughout the world, that God will bring new courage to leaders of nations in working for peace and ending injustice. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are graduating, that God will guide them, help their faith to mature, and inspire them to use their gifts for the good of others. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Rochester area Catholic family of parishes, that we may allow God to bring us into the life of the Trinity, to deepen a relationship with us, and to become the center of our hearts and lives. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill in body, mind, or spirit, especially Sarah Kennedy, that the healing spirit of God's love will strengthen them and bring them to wholeness quickly. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faithful departed, especially Gerald Griffin, may they now see the vision of the Trinity for which we hope. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intercessions placed in our prayer basket, and for Father Grayson Heenan, Father Steve Burr, and Norma Palak, from whom this Mass is offered. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we offer these prayers to Christ, our risen Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him who build the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God. In his ways, in his wisdom, he strengthens us like gold that's tested in fire. Though the power of sin prevails, our God is there to save. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. Every moment of every day, our God is waiting to save. Always ready to seek the lost, to answer those who pray. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. God has watered our barren land and spent his merciful rain. Now the rivers of life run full for anyone to drink. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. Many he bears to those
those who trust in his ways.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and ever to you, thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with the only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord. Not in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity and substance, and their quality and majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you have life to all things to make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
this bread and drink this cup. We proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as you celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as you look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may attain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, bless us of her spouse, with us apostles, glorious martyrs, with Saint Andrew, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to prayers of this family whom has summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who please you pass in this life, give kind and minister your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, and for my divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grace and grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as you await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look down on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grace to grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Let
sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed was called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Other home.
and eat this bread, my life for you. Take and drink this wine, my life live in you. Love one another, love one another as I fall on my knees to the Father of Jesus, the Lord who has shown us the glory of God. May Christ in his love give us strength for our living, the strength of the Spirit, the glory of God. May Christ find a dwelling place of faith in our hearts. May our lives be rooted in love, rooted in
Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul. As you confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I don't think I've ever given a homily on concomitants. A lot of big words today on Holy Trinity Sunday. Each weekend in June, we will hold a food drive to support the needs of Neighborhood House. Also, there are tickets available for the July 22nd Tigers game. Details are in the bulletin. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Holy God, we praise thy name. Lord of all, we bow before thee. All on earth thy sanctuary. With sweet